Very good morning to all the students of class plus 2C. Yes, Pita, we are going to start a new chapter, Should Wizard Hit Mommy? Fine. So this is a kind of question as the title. Fine. And when you read the title, you won't be able to understand or you won't be able to have any idea about that what the chapter is all about. So who is a wizard first? Wizard is the person who has magical powers. Okay, when we call it, he's a wizard. Fine, the person who can perform some magic, that person is known as wizard. Fine, you might have seen in fictional movies and all, a person is moving magic wand and then he's giving some instructions and that thing is happening. So that person is a wizard. Fine, in that way. Very good. Yes. So now the question arises, should wizard hit mommy? Clear, the name of the chapter. But this actually, this is a story within a story. Fine. So there are two stories in this chapter. First, I have written characters in one part. Second story, I have written characters in the second part. So please, that's why I'm saying that I was texting you all that please join the class. Otherwise, you won't be able to understand. So let me introduce the characters of the story first. In this story, there are basically, you can say one more character is there, but that is passive character. So there is one family. The protagonist of this chapter is Jack. Fine. Jack is father of a four-year-old girl, Joe. Clear? So Jack being the protagonist, then Joe, we have the daughter of Jack. Then Claire. Claire is wife of Jack. Fine. So our protagonist is Jack here. Protagonist means a main character. Clear? Joe or Joanne is full name, but in nickname we will be using Joe only. Clear? So Joe is daughter. She is also main character. Joe is also one of the prominent characters of the story. Then we have Claire, who's wife of Jack. And then fourth is Bobby. He is a son of Jack. Clear? Protagonist ke relation mein kya hai, sir? But Bobby does not have any, you can say, role in the story, but that's all we know about this chapter. Okay, so these are the characters, basic characters of this story. Please send me thumbs up if it is clear to you about Jack, Joe, Claire, and Bobby. Is it clear? But please keep sending me your feedback so that I can continue. Fine. Then we have story within the story. Now, what does the story goes? Jack, who's the protagonist, you know, he very quite oftenly he tells stories to his four-year-old daughter Joe. You know that at this age, when children are just, you know, growing up and they believe in fictional things, they believe in imaginary world. You tell them that there is heaven, they will say, okay. You tell them that there is a wizard and ghost and that kind of thing, they do believe. They start believing in the things. Clear? So, in this, Joe believes in whatever is told by Jack. Fine? And basically, Jack narrates the same story to Joe on daily basis during the afternoon naps. Fine? Jab hum bachche ko sulane jaate hain, we start narrating the stories in that way. So Jack narrates basic story to Joe. Characters of that story are written here. Fine. So ye kaun se characters hai? These characters actually belong to the story narrated by Jack. So the Jack, you can say Jack narrates one particular story on daily basis, same story. He just changes the characters, but story remains the same. Clear? So what is that story that I will be telling you? Just wait. What is that story? The story says, Jack tells that there is a, you can say, one character, Roger Skunk. And that Roger Skunk, you know, has a problem. And he goes to visit, that Roger Skunk goes to a wise old owl. Fine? At last, I have written, you can see. A wise old owl is there in the forest. So Roger Skunk goes there to solve that problem. And wise old owl suggests him that you should go to wizard, a person who has magical powers. So Roger Skunk says, okay. Then Roger Skunk goes to wizard. Wizard moves his magic wand and the problem of Roger Skunk is solved. Fine. So this is the basic storyline, which is narrated by Jack to his four-year-old daughter Jo on daily basis. Fine. So this is the basic line. Now let me talk about the theme of this chapter. What is the theme? Please note down. Need to inculcate moral values among children. So that's why we narrate stories to our children. And while narrating the stories, you know, while narrating the stories, we tell them, you know, a moral at the end, so that children remember that, okay, we should speak truth, we should do this, these are the good habits, this should not be done. So in that way, that is the prominent theme. Then next is bond between parent and child, how we can improve it by narrating them stories, by spending them quality time, fine, by preaching them good values, by inculcating moral values in them. Then do not look for instant solutions in life. Have patience. So this story will also give one message to us that you should not look for the instant solutions. So this is the world where we are impatient. We just find quick solutions. But this story will also tell us that we need to keep patience. Fine. Then a very important theme is imaginary world of the children. Should we encourage it or not? Means this is a question mark. Should Wizard hit mommy? Fine, should Wizard hit mommy? Actually, this is a question posed by Jo to her father, Jack. Fine. You can say she wants that this should be done. But now, which is morally not correct. You know that sometimes when you can say Jack keeps on telling the same story to Jo, and one day she retaliates. One day she does not accept it. One day she wants to add up her own element. Fine, that Wizard should hit mommy. Now the question is whether we should encourage the creativity of children, that imaginary world of children, or we should preach them the fixed moral values. You know, children are very creative. They have n number of questions in their minds. Should we answer them? Or should we let them explore the world as they want? Or we should teach them, this is the way you should think. Fine? So, you know, Einstein used to say that, don't teach your children what to do. You know, teach them that how to do this, or you can say where to. Don't tell them where to look, tell them how to look at the thing. Fine. So we just, you know, keep on teaching the fixed things to our children, that this is the way it should be done, but we never let them be their own self. Their individuality is actually a shadow of our own behavior. So this is the open-ended chapter in which question is left for the readers, that should Wizard hit mommy in this story, which is morally not good, but as per a child's imagination, this is correct. Fine. So she will be giving a very good logic also. So first of all, beta, sabko clear hai? Please, maximum students are joining. That's very good. Please send me a thumbs up. Jitna maine bola hai, abhi aapko clear ho gaya. I will be sharing the screen now. Send me thumbs up, jaldi se beta. Is it clear to you all? Quick, yes, very good. Let me show you. Now I'll be sharing screen. I'll be showing you what is a skunk. See, this is the picture of skunk you are seeing on your screens. Can you see? Skunk is this animal. It is, you can say, cat sized mammal. So it's just like, it looks like a squirrel. You can see it has bigger tail. Fine. So this is the character of the story of you can say narrated by Jack. Okay, so he changes the animal all the time. Sometimes he just chooses that, but the name remains the same. Roger is that character. Clear? So this is that animal. Is it clear, beta? Let's share the screen of the chapter now. Beta, screen is visible. Keep on responding so that I can continue. Yes. Should Wizard Hit Mommy by John Updike. Before you read, here is a story about the world view of a little child and the difficult moral question the she raises during the story session with her father. You know, sometimes children are so, you can say, they, you know, think out of the box. They think very uniquely, even an adult cannot think. So they're very imaginary, you know, they very, very creative. So, you know, each day that father narrates a story. Now, during the story, now this four-year-old girl, earlier when she was two or she was three, she used to accept whatever was told by Jack. But now she's not able to accept it. Fine. And she raises a question. So let's start the story. Please, beta, be there throughout the session. In the evenings and for Saturday naps like today's, Jack told his daughter Jo a story out of his head. Out of his head means he himself thinks, he himself creates the stories. This custom, you know, customize karwate hain jaise hum cheezon ko. He customized the stories. This custom began. So actually this this custom, this rule, you can say, jo kab start hua tha, began when she was two, was itself now nearly 2 years old. Fine. His head felt empty. So when she was 2 years old, then he started narrating stories, and now she, almost 2 years ho chuke hain, and he's out of ideas. Head felt empty means he's not having ideas anymore. 2 saal tak usne itni story suna di hai Roger name ke character ki, then now he's out of ideas. Each new story was a slight variation of a basic tale. Fine. So you should know this, beta, very important. What was the basic tale narrated by Jack? A small creature, usually named Roger, sometimes Roger Fish, Roger Squirrel, Roger Chipmunk, had some problem and went with it to the wise owl, old owl. The owl told him to go to the wizard, and wizard performed a magic spell that solved the problem, demanding in payment a number of pennies greater than the number that Roger creature had. But in the same breath, directing the animal to a place where the extra pennies could be found. Fine. Now, please listen to the story. Kya story Jack suna raha tha? He used to tell the story that there is one character, Jack, one character, Roger. Kabhi wo Roger Fish hota, kabhi wo Roger Squirrel. Story same rehti, but he would change the name. Roger Chipmunk, animal ko change karta tha, creature ko. And that main character of the story, he would have some problem and he would go to the wise old owl in the forest. So old owl would ask him to go to the wizard, that, you know, wizard is the person with magical powers, and wizard would perform a magic spell or Roger ki problem solve ho jati thi. Or in return that, you know, wizard would ask for pennies. Usko paise mangta tha ki please give some money, and always he would ask for the money which he was not having. So always Roger would have less number of pennies, and wizard would demand more pennies. And then Roger was saddened after this. Then wizard would always give instructions that where he could find extra pennies. Wo ye bhi batata wizard, okay, wahan pe jao, wahan pe tujhe paise mil jayenge. And then Roger would come back and he would hand over the money to wizard for helping him. And then he would play with other creatures in the forest. And then he would go back home, because his father was about to reach home by taking the train from Boston. Clear? So yehi story wo suna raha hai usko. Jack described their supper. Then Jack would tell ki wo kya kya khate the. Supper means dinner, beta. And then the story was over. So this is the story. So by telling this story, which moral values is trying to inculcate? Anyone could tell me? Anyone? Kya values inculcate karne ki koshish ho rahi hai yahan pe? When Jack is narrating the story of Roger creature to 4 year old Joe, what values he is trying to inculcate? Yes, Anushka. कोई भी एक वैल्यू आप बता सकते हो, क्या सिखा रहा है स्टोरी से उसको. प्लीज पार्टिसिपेट सो दैट आई कैन सी दैट यू आर लिसनिंग. सम्यक, आपने कभी आंसर नहीं किया, यू टेल इफ यू आर अटेंडिंग द क्लास. Samyak, are you there? See, when I ask the questions, then only few students, they participate. Rana, anyone value? See, this is the waste, sheer wastage of time. Sheer wastage of time. When I ask you some question, class mein bhi to aap answer karte the na? So I'm not going to mark them present who are not giving answers. Yes, Gaurav. Aap to hamesha answer back karte ho. Let's see. Jack is narrating a story to his four-year-old daughter Jo. Which value he is trying to inculcate? Beta, are you able to listen to me, children? Is there any connectivity problem? I'll continue then. I won't be waiting to waste the time. So, fine, in this, actually he's trying to inculcate values, like he's teaching them that always if problem is there in life, solutions can also be there. So he's teaching his child that. Then he would describe the importance of parents also, that how Roger would return back home just to see his father coming back from work. Then they would have their dinner together, family time. Fine. Then many values from that story he is trying to inculcate in his daughter. Okay. So working his way through this scheme was especially fatiguing on Saturday, because Joe never fell asleep in naps anymore. And knowing this made the ride seem futile. So actually every Saturday when during the afternoon, naps are the afternoon time when the children sleep. So it was very fatiguing, very tiring, because father kept on putting efforts and daughter was not at all sleeping. It was futile. It was of no use. So the little girl, not so little anymore, the bumps her feet under the covers were halfway down the bed. Their big double bed that they let her be in for naps and when she was sick, had at last arranged herself, and from the way her fat face deep in the pillow shone in the sunlight, sifting through the drawn shades, it did not seem fantastic that some magic would occur and she would take her nap like an infant of two. Her brother Bobby was two and already asleep with his bottle. Jack asked, who shall the story be about today? So in this paragraph, actually, beta, they are narrating that when she was 2 year old, she would sleep very easily. But now she's 4 year old, having a lot of imagination, a lot of energy, a lot of on thinking level, and she's not at all being befooled by parents. She's not at all sleeping. Her brother is 2 year old, now he's sleeping by having his milk bottle, but she's not able to sleep. So that's why father is asking, who shall the story be about today? Aaj kaun si story sunni hai? Though the story was same daily, Roger, Joe squeezed her eyes and shut and smiled to be thinking she was thinking. You know, at this age, children are very, you know, expressive. So they are learning new things. They're exploring the world. So she squeezed her eyes and smiled as if she's thinking. Bahut kuch soch rahi hai wo. And her eyes opened. Her mother's blue skunk, she said firmly. So she said, after thinking for a while, she says that skunk. Today's animal should be skunk. So, maine abhi aapko skunk dikhaya tha, so you can imagine. A new animal, they must talk about skunks at nursery school. So, she might have heard this at her school. That's why she knows, because she's 4 year old and she's going to that pre-primary. And she might have heard this word. So, wo kehta ki achha, aaj new animal hai. So, the story remains the same, that Roger would have some problem. Roger would go to owl. Owl will ask him to go to wizard. Wizard will move her wand and solve the problem of Roger. And then wizard would ask for money and Roger's skunk would be out of money or less money he will be having. And then wizard will tell, go to that place, you will get money. And then after giving money to wizard, Roger Skunk would be playing with other creatures and would come back home and have dinner and sleep. So this is the basic story, clear? But the animal is new now. So he's thinking she might have heard about skunks at nursery school having a fresh hero momentarily stirred Jack to creative enthusiasm. So Jack thought, ki fine, this is something new. New character is added up. All right, he said, once upon a time in the deep, dark woods, there was a tiny little creature by the name of Roger Skunk. And he smelled very bad. You know that some animals do have stinky smells. So this skunk, you know, is considered, he smelled very bad and he smelled like that. Yes, Joe said. He smelled so bad that none of the other woodland creatures would play with him. So he changed his story a bit here, that due to the smell of that Roger Skunk, nobody would play with him because he would smell bad. Jo looked at him solemnly. She had not foreseen this. Whenever he would go out to play, Jack continued with zest, remembering certain humiliations of his own childhood, all of the other tiny animals would cry, oh, here comes Roger Stinky Skunk. And they would run away. And Roger Skunk would stand there all alone. And two little round tears would fall from his eyes. The corners of Joe's mouth drooped down and her lower lip bent forward as he traced with a forefinger along the side of her nose and the course of one of Roger Skunk's tears. Now, let me tell you, in our lives, there are some times when we are also being bullied by others. Aap apni upar hi leke dekhna kabhi. That in the class, sometimes, you know, others insult you, other friends humiliate you, they comment upon something and you feel really bad at that time. Fine. Everybody, I'm not saying about one person, every one of us have better experiences of life, one or the other. So Jack, protagonist of this story, who's father of Joe, he did have, you know, bad childhood days. When he was a kid, he also, you know, saw the discrimination. So, kai baar aap different nazar aate ho kisi se. Koi zyada mota hai, koi zyada patla hai, koi skinny, koi tall zyada hai, koi short hai. You know, and it is very common scene that your friends and you can say classmates, you know, they would make fun of that particular feature, which is not, you can say, good according to them. And maybe Joe had, you know, I witnessed that as a child. Jack, jo girl ka father hai, protagonist story ka, Jack. So Jack might have, you know, I witnessed some kind of discrimination. So wo usi ko hi actually wo story form mein suna raha hai abhi. Jaise Roger Skunk hai. And Roger Skunk actually wo, he's expressing his own viewpoint, his own suppressed emotions, ki jaise uske saath bachpan mein hota tha, children would run and they would never play with him. Clear? Please keep me sending thumbs up if you are clear so far. Questions to aapne bolne nahi hai. At least give me the feedback that you are able to understand what's going on in the class. So he is actually giving, vent to his own feelings that Roger Skunk was not having any other friends. Okay? And he would cry. And the moment he is describing the situation, expressions of Joe could be seen. Joe is showing such expressions of, you can say, sadness. Okay. Won't he see the owl? She asked in a high and faintly roughened voice. So usko pata hai ab to Roger ko problem aa gayi hai. And he will see the owl. Usko pata hai ye storyline to yehi rehta hai. She asked her father. Sitting on the bed beside her, Jack felt the covers tug as her legs twitched tensely. He was pleased with his moment. He was telling her something true. Something she must know and had no wish to hurry on. But downstairs, a chair scraped, and he realized he must get down to help Claire paint the living room woodwork. So actually, they are telling sometimes we are stuck in such situations. And this time, in the story of Roger Skunk, he is narrating something true. जो उसके साथ खुद के साथ हुआ था discrimination as a child. So he is not in a hurry. So he is having that patience to narrate the story to her 4-year-old daughter. He is not at all, you know, he is not rushing कि okay story finish करके जाऊं. He is, you know, weaving that story, weaving the threads of the story so that he could inculcate some moral values in his daughter. But जैसे ही वो story continue करने वाला होता है, नीचे से उसको आवाज आती है, downstairs a chair scraped. Actually, his wife Claire, she is carrying third child. She is pregnant with third child, and she is working all alone in the living room. She is painting the that woodwork she is doing. So he is thinking ki whether they are having two kids and they are expecting their third one. So he is thinking, should I help my wife over there or shall I continue the story? But usko karna padega story because she is not still asleep. Well, he walked along very sadly and came to a very big tree. He yahan pe kaun hai? Roger Skunk. So Jack continues the story that Roger walked along very sadly and came to a very big tree. And in the tiptoe of the tree was an enormous wise old owl. Enormous means big. Good, Mr. Owl, Roger Skunk said. All the other little animals run away from me because I smell so bad. So Mr. Owl ke paas wo jata hai. And Mr. Owl ko wo story batata hai ki I am Roger Skunk and I smell so bad. Nobody wants to play with me. Very, very bad. So what can I do? Roger Skunk said, and he cried very hard. So actually, again, I'm telling you here, Jack is narrating his own emotions. He cried very hard. It is being used for Skunk, that character of Jack's story. But Jack himself has eyewitnessed this as a child. The wizard, Joe shouted. You know that now, next story mein kaun aayega? That owl will give the advice to go to the wizard now. So she says, wizard. And she was so excited. A little golden book spilled from the bed. Now, Joe, daddy is telling the story. Do you want to tell daddy the story? No, you, me. Then lie down and be sleepy. So in between, Jack is giving instructions to his daughter so that she sleeps also. But she's all the more excited. She's not sleeping. Her head relapsed onto the pillow and she said, out of your head. Well, the owl thought and thought. At last he said, why don't you go to see the wizard? Daddy, what? Are magic spells real? This is the question she never asked earlier. When she was 2-year-old, when she was 3-year-old, she would listen to the story as it is, the way it was narrated to her. But now she has started asking such realistic questions because she is now turning into, she's growing up now. She's having her own IQ. She's thinking harder now. Wo puchti hai ki magic spells sach mein hote hai kya? Are magic spells real? This was a new phase now. What the new phase? A reality phase. When he told her spiders eat bugs, she turned to her mother and asked, do they really? Means jab aap usko factual information milni shuru hui hai reality ki, she used to confirm from other members of the family. When her father told her one day that spiders eat bugs, then she asked her mother, ki, is it true? And when Claire told her that God was in the sky and all around them, she asked her father with a sly yet eager smile, is he really? Is it true? जो फादर बताता था वो मदर से कंफर्म करती थी और मदर जो कोई फैक्ट बताता था तो फादर से. Then she asked that father whether these magic spells are true. Answer given by father is they are real in stories. Stories में real होते हैं. Jack answered curtly. She had made him miss a beat in the narrative. The owl missed a beat means वो story सुना रहा था बीच में she asked some other question. The owl said, now he continued the story. Go through the dark woods under the apple trees into the swamp over the creek. So he says, the owl said, go through the dark woods that apple trees will come under the apple trees into the swamp and over the creek. What's a creek? Now she's asking questions. He tells a little river. So he answers it, a little river. Over the creek and there will be the wizard's house. And that's the way Roger Skunk went. And pretty soon he came to a little white house and he rapped on the door. Jack rapped on the windowsill. And under the covers, Joe's tall figure clenched in an infantile thrill. And then a tiny little old man came out with a long white beard and long pointed blue hat and said, hey, what's this? What do you want? What you want means what do you want? You smell awful. The wizard's voice was one of Jack's own favorite effects. He did it by scrunching up his face and somehow whining through his eyes, which felt for the interval roomy. He felt being an old man suited him. So while, becoming the voiceover of that wizard, Jack would, make his voice heavier and squint his eyes and, by changing that tone, that was a favorite part of Jack in the story. So he would now speak the dialogue of wizard. I know it, Roger Skunk said. And all the little animals run away from me. Jab usko wizard bolta, you smell awful. Roger Skunk kehta, I know, wizard. And all the animals run away from me. The enormous wise owl said, you could help me. Enormous means big. So we will continue tomorrow, beta. Bell ho chuki hai. Please do read jitna humne kara hai. Otherwise, you won't be able to. And if any doubt is there, you can ask me. Okay? Is it clear? Jaldi se thumbs up bhejiye. Is it clear to you? Story within the story. Chali. Okay, beta. Please do it in the class tomorrow also.